Hi everyone, Lee Magpie here, and today we've got something else Pokemon related, and this is the Pokemon Articulated Epic Battle Figure, Arillaboom, and this looks absolutely awesome. I got it as a Christmas present, but I do note that it retails in Smiths for £20, which is a really good price because it is a really big figure, and the packaging's all new with this like red, white and grey theme with Pokeballs in the background, and then it's got a Pokeball in the corner here, and it's for Forum Plus, and there is the name there, and it just has the Pokemon logo at the top with Pikachu, and it comes with an accessory, a drum, which I can't wait to have a look at that and see what all that's about. And obviously it's articulated, and I can't wait to check out its little, well, its drumsticks. I'm just going to lift up the camera a little bit more there. And then on the back of the packaging, well, on the side of the packaging, it's just got a picture of Pikachu, and it just says Epic Battle Figure. And then on the back of the packaging, it just shows you some available figures. I think Gastly looks really cool. I've got Arcanine, and I did a review on that one. It's got Psyduck, Flareon, and then some of the smaller figures. I'm not a big fan of the Machamp figure. I don't think that looks very cool compared to the Termi version. And yeah, it looks really cool. I really like the red and white theme to represent the Pokeball colours. And the figure is quite a big figure. I will link it in the description box down below for Smiths. And hopefully you might be able to, well, it might be already on Amazon. I haven't checked to see if it was on Amazon. And it's an open box. So that's different because these bigger figures, I think you'd like to look at them properly. A bit like the Venusaur. So, yeah, without further ado, I'm going to get Arillaboom out of the packaging. So everyone, I've got Arillaboom out of the packaging, and my overall thoughts is he looks absolutely awesome. He's very large and in charge and a very cool figure. He's got quite a few details, but it's quite simplistic because that's just how the look in the anime and films and games. But first, I'm going to show you the accessory, which is his drum, which looks really nicely done. It's simplistic, it's just a plastic, it's a good plastic, it's not, don't feel cheap, it's just a normal plastic. It's got two sides what look the same on each side, and then it's just got some little bits of wood detailing, but it's done very like a simplistic paint app. It doesn't look like real wood, but it looks really cool. It'd be kind of cool to do a repaint on this and actually make it look like real wood. But it's really cool. Just a nice little accessory, which he is always advertised with in the games and stuff like that. So it's nice that they've added that. And then here is Arillaboom all in his full glory. Looks absolutely awesome. The face expression they've done on him looks really nicely done. He's got some really nice sculpting on the face, and he literally just looks like, well, it just looks like the game. I love his little fringe bit, which is like a green van around his, going down his face. Just looks like a rock star. And yeah, he looks really nicely done. There is a tiny bit of a paint blemish there, but it's not like a real big deal. And he just looks really clean, really nicely done. And this bit on the back is like a really heavy plastic, but it's sculpted really nice. This is like his mane, what's made out of like grass, his grass mane. It's a bit more of a matte green. It's just coming off a bit brighter on camera. But it's really nicely sculpted and got a good texture to it. And then he's got some bits of texturing around the sides with the same green, and the same goes around with his cuffs with some little bits of sculpt detailing, these like a bit of crease detailing there. He's got a real nice weight to him. He's not heavy and he's not light at the same time. It's just a nice weight overall. And he just looks awesome. I think the plate around his, well, his chest area is really nicely done and it's risen. It's like a risen plastic. It's not flat. Like the like sculpted two areas onto his chest. And then he's got these printed little areas on his arms as well. And then he's got like a rib definition sculpted all in this nice creamish grey colour. And then his body's like a browny, it's like a brown, a real dark brown with a tinge of grey. And then his arms are really nicely done as well. His knuckles or hands look really nicely done in the same grey. And then his drumsticks have got quite nice little bits of details. You can see it's got some like ridge details in it there. He just looks awesome. There's his feet up close as well. As you can see, there's a joint there. I'm going to show you his articulation in a sec. But yeah, his face sculpt looks really nicely done. I love this little bit of 3D, like, risen plastic going around his eye here. As you can see there. And then the back of him looks like this. As you can see there, he's got some print work at the back with these shapes. I scratched the little bit of plastic there, which is a bit, it's a bit upsetting to be fair, but it's not too bad. It was because it was really tricky to get out the packaging. But it's not too bad. At least it's at the back so you can't really see it. And he just looks so large and in charge. He's such a big figure. I was a bit scared that he was going to be a bit top heavy. I think sometimes it could be, depending. Like, I think I've spoke too soon. But yeah, looks absolutely awesome. And the mouth area has some really nice details as well. As you can see, it's really nicely painted. He's got his mouth open, he looks angry, ready to play some rock music or drum music. And that's really nicely painted as well. So now I'm going to show you the articulation. As you can see, he's got really large arms, so he can move his arms all the way around like that. He can move his arm out like that. So he's got a joint there. And same goes for this arm, so he can do some really good drumming action or he can do some good punching action, so that's really good. And then the same goes for the legs, he can move his legs out like that, pretty much go all the way around, and his legs can go out like that, so he can do like a kicking action. You could probably stand him like that if you balanced him just right. He can, that's without me holding him. He looks really, really cool. So you've got some really good posability. You can put him in a few poses as well. And then it just looks really good. Just stood there and with his drum. Obviously, I'm going to hold him for this bit. But you could probably make him look like he's banging the drum as well. And just let him live his best life. So he'll be real good for all purposes. He's a real strong figure. He feels real strong. He feels like he wouldn't just break. So play purposes, perfect. Obviously, photography purposes, perfect. Really good articulation. Quite standard, but enough. He hasn't got no swivel joints or anything like that in his wrists, but I don't think he needs that. And he hasn't got any more articulation around here because obviously this is all one piece and it'd be quite a struggle to move his head around. But comes with a nice little accessory as well. And overall just looks awesome. And that pose overall looks really cool. And if you're a Pokemon fan, you'll absolutely love this figure. It's a real nice price as well for the size of the figure. And I just can't wait to do some photography of him, which I have an Instagram which is called Liam_Magpie. I do lots of updates on there for toy reviews. I do photography on there. I do updates on new toys what may be coming out. So follow me on there for more toy reviews and more toy content on there. And yeah, I am done with this review. I think it is an absolute awesome figure. Everything is a... If I was to give this a full scale to 1 to 10, I'd give everything a 10 out of 10. It just looks awesome. There isn't one bad word I can say about it. It's a little... It can be maybe a little bit top heavy. But as you can see, you can put him literally on one leg and balance him out. You could probably just put him in like a proper gorilla pose and stand him like that. That looks really cool as well. So it's got loads of posability. And it comes with a little accessory. His signature drum. So yeah, I'm done with this review. So please like and subscribe to my channel. Hit that alarm bell for more toy related stuff and more toy episodes. I've got a few more toy stuff coming up soon as well. I've got some Sylvanian families. I've got some Jurassic World. So if you love Sylvanians, like and subscribe. If you like Jurassic World, like and subscribe. Or you just like a big mixed range of toys, like and subscribe to my channel. I am done with this review and hope to see you on the next one. And I'll link this cool, amazing figure in the description box down below. Pokemon fans, get your hands on this figure and I'll see you all on the next one. Bye guys!